Welcome to Linear Integrated Circuits and Applications Lab. Today we will perform experiment number 8. Aim of this experiment is to study and analyze the working of operational amplifier IC741 as a Schmitt trigger. Operators required: IC741, breadboard, various resistors, jumper wires, function generator, DSO, DSO probes, and DC power supply. Theory: op amp as a Schmitt trigger. A Schmitt trigger is a comparator circuit with hysteresis implemented by applying positive feedback to the non-inverting input of a comparator or a differential amplifier. It is an active circuit which converts an analog input signal to a digital output signal. This circuit is named a trigger because the output retains its value until the input changes sufficiently to trigger a change. In the non-inverting configuration, when the input is higher than a certain chosen threshold, the output is high. When the input is below a different chosen threshold, the output is low. And when the input is between the two levels, the output retains its value. This dual threshold action is called hysteresis. This is a circuit diagram of op amp as a Schmitt trigger. In this circuit, input signal Vin is applied to pin number 2 through resistor Rin. The value of this resistor is equal to the parallel combination of R1 and RF, and a voltage divider circuit is implemented with the help of R1 and RF and connected to pin number 3. A positive feedback is used in this circuit. A feedback resistor of 330 kilo ohm is connected between pin number 6 and pin number 3. Pin number 7th and 4th are used for plus VCC and minus VEE DC power supply. The output of this circuit is observed at pin number 6, which is output pin of this IC. A Schmitt trigger is basically an inverting comparator circuit with a positive feedback. The purpose of the Schmitt trigger is to convert any regular or irregular shaped input waveform into a square wave output voltage or pulse. Thus, it can also be called a squaring circuit. As shown in the circuit diagram, a voltage divider with the resistors R1 and RF is set in the positive feedback of the IC741. The same values of R1 and RF are used to get the resistance value Rin is equal to the parallel combination of R1 and RF, which is connected in the series with the input voltage. Rin is used to minimize the offset problems. The voltage across R1 is feedback to the non-inverting input of IC. Input voltage triggers or changes the state of output voltage every time it exceeds its voltage level above a certain threshold value called upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage. This is input and output waveforms of a Schmitt trigger. As we apply sine wave as input signal to this Schmitt trigger, and we will get square wave as output. And also we have to observe positive saturation voltage and negative saturation voltage of the output voltage. And then we have to calculate upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage. When Vout is equal to positive saturation, the voltage across R1 is called upper threshold voltage. The input voltage must be slightly more positive than upper threshold voltage in order to cause the output voltage to switch from positive saturation to negative saturation. When the input voltage is less than upper threshold voltage, the output voltage is at positive saturation. This is formula to calculate upper threshold voltage. When Vout is equal to negative saturation voltage, the voltage across R1 is called lower threshold voltage. The input voltage must be slightly more negative than lower threshold voltage in order to cause the output voltage to switch from negative saturation to positive saturation. When the input voltage is less than lower threshold voltage, the output voltage is at negative saturation. This is formula to calculate lower threshold voltage. If the value of upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage are higher than the input noise voltage, the positive feedback will eliminate the false output transitions. With the help of positive feedback and its regenerative behavior, the output voltage will switch fast between the positive and negative saturation voltage. Procedure for connections. This is circuit diagram of op amp as a Schmitt trigger. First of all, arrange all the components which are required for this experiment. For this, we need IC741, resistor Rin, R1 and RL, each of 10 kilo ohm, a feedback resistor of 330 kilo ohm, and also we need a function generator for input signal, a DC power supply for plus VCC and minus VEE DC voltage, and also we need an oscilloscope for measurement of output as well as input of this circuit. Now arrange all the components one by one. This is IC741, 8 pin IC. These are three resistors of 10 kilo ohm each. This is 330 kilo ohm resistor. This is breadboard. These are some male to male jumper wires. Now, first step is insert this IC into the breadboard and keep this bubble on upper side so that we can easily identify the pins of this IC. Insert this IC into breadboard like this. This is pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, next step is connection of a 10 kilo ohm resistor as R in. This is the 10 kilo ohm resistor. Insert one end into pin number 2 and the other end will be connected to input signal. Input signal is given from the function generator. These two jumper wires, brown and black, are connected to a function generator through a BNC to crocodile cable. Brown is main and black is ground. Brown wire will be connected to resistor like this, and black wire is connected to ground of breadboard. All the connections related to ground, like ground of input signal, one terminal of resistor R1, one terminal of resistor RL, ground of output prop and ground of DC power supply. All these ground signals are connected to a common terminal. For this track is vertically shorted up to this point. All the grounds are connected to this vertical shorted track. And now next step is connections of R1. This is 10 kilo ohm resistor connected between pin number 3 and ground. This is pin number 3, and other end of this resistor would be connected to ground like this. Connection of a feedback resistor. This is 330 kilo ohm resistor. This resistor would be connected to pin number 6 and 3. This is pin number 6 and this is pin number 3. Now connection of load resistor. This 10 kilo ohm resistor would be connected as a load resistor like this. And next step is connection of DC power supply to pin number 7th and 4th. For this, these three jumper wires, yellow, red and black, are connected to a DC power supply. Yellow is connected to plus 12 volt, red is connected to minus 12 volt, and this black jumper wire is connected to ground of DC power supply. And keep the DC power supply at off position. Connect this yellow wire to pin number 7. And now red wire to pin number 4. And ground would be connected to ground of this breadboard. Now, next step is connection of an oscilloscope at output of this circuit. For this, these two jumper wires are connected to a DSO through BNC to crocodile cable. Red wire is connected to output pin and black wire is connected to ground of breadboard like this. And also we have to measure input signal on DSO. For this, these two jumper wires are connected to input of this circuit. Yellow wire is connected to this point and black is connected to ground of breadboard. And these two jumper wires are connected to channel 1 of a DSO. Now, procedure for observations. This is experimental setup of op-amp as a Schmitt trigger. Input of this Schmitt trigger is given from this function generator. This is DC power supply plus VCC and minus VEE. DC voltage are given from this DC power supply. This is DSO output signal as well as input signal of this circuit be observed on this oscilloscope. Output signal of this circuit is connected to channel 2. Input signal of this circuit is connected to channel 1 of this DSO. Now switch on the function generator and DSO. Input signal Vin is directly connected to channel 1 of DSO through this cables. Select sine wave of 1 kilohertz, 1 volt peak to peak, and then press on button. This input signal is directly visible on this DSO. Now switch on the DC power supply. Channel 2 and channel 3 are connected to pin number 7th and 4th of this IC. Channel 2 and channel 3. Press on button simultaneously and observe output of this circuit. This is output of this Schmitt trigger, and we have to measure upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage. For this, measure positive saturation voltage and negative saturation voltage of this output signal. For this, we have to measure Vmax and Vminimum of this signal. Select Vmax and Vminimum of channel 2. As we observed, Vmax is equal to 10.80 and Vminimum is 9.60 volt. Put these values on formula to calculate upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage of this circuit. Precautions: keep the DC power supply in off condition while making connections. Do not increase the input voltage above the specification level. It may lead to the damage of the IC. The connecting wires should not be shorted together, and also check their connections with the breadboard. Thanks.